Hello and welcome to Master in Market. My name is Grady Arno. I'm an associate director here at Duke's Fuqua School of Business, and I have the pleasure of speaking with Vinaik today from the MQM class of 2022. Hello, Vinaik. How are you?
Doing great, Grady. How are you doing?
I'm great. Thank you so much for being here today. Really excited to talk to you and get to know you a little bit better about your role that you're currently in. So if you want to start with an introduction, that'd be fantastic.
Sure. Thank you, Grady. My name is Vinaik Gautam. I was a member of the MQM class of 2022, where I graduated about a little bit over a year ago. During the MQM program, I was part of the finance track, and some of the extracurriculars that I was involved in was being an admission ambassador, so working very closely with Grady, making sure the admitted students' day went off without a hitch, and also asking any prospective students if they had any questions about the program in general. I was also involved in the South Asian Society as well as the Finance Club, but my favorite extracurricular was being a part of the Duke University Marching and Pep Band. I play alto saxophone, so I was able to perform at all of the men's basketball, women's basketball, and even the Duke football games. I'm still involved with the alumni band. We perform 2 or 3 times a year. As you can see, I'm a big Duke proponent. I really love Duke and really excited to be here. Before Duke, though, I was a undergraduate student at Northeastern University, where I majored in math and finance. So the reason to coming to Duke was to marry my math and finance knowledge with a technical skill set. And that's led to my current role at MFS Investment Management, where I'm currently a quantitative research associate.
That's so exciting. Thank you so much for sharing that. And if anyone's interested on Vinaik's experiences in the marching band, there is a blog about it, which is really a great read if you're interested in doing those extracurricular activities. So tell us a little bit about your role as a quantitative research associate at MFS Investment Management.
Sure. Before I just get into that, I'll give a bit of a company background on what we do. So MFS Investment Management is one of the oldest asset management companies in the world. We are credited with pioneering the first ever open-ended mutual fund called Massachusetts Investor Trust in 1924, and it's still in the market today. So folks can still invest into the mutual fund if they please. I work in the investments department, so it's around 300 or so employees for that department, and we're really structured in 3 different functions. The first one and probably the biggest one is the fundamental equity team. So these are research analysts and portfolio managers that are basically like our stock pickers. So they research each and every company. They know all of their financial statements back and forth. And they also speak to the management teams like the CEO or the head of investor relations to get an idea about growth prospects going forward. We then have our fixed income team. So they invest a lot in fixed income securities. They're looking at things like credit bonds, yields, liquidity ratios. And then again, very similar to the fundamental equity team, investing in attractive investment options. And then finally, we have the quantitative solutions team, which I'm a part of as a quant research associate. And we develop quantitative models based on factor research, such as research that's been conducted at the Duke Fuqua School of Business. And based on that research, we then develop models based on those factors. And as a quantitative research associate, I help with the analysts and the PMs in that process of constructing our models, along with any client needs that they might have or other data regulations that may be required too.
So it sounds like there's a lot going on in your role working with a variety of key stakeholders. So what does your day-to-day look like?
Yeah, definitely. I would say that not every day is the same, but it does follow a bit of a structure. So I'm usually in the office around 8 to 8:30 after checking my emails or following up with anything that were left over from yesterday. I'll usually have a request that comes in from a sector team. So at MFS, we have different sectors. We have like the technology sector, for example. And these are analysts and portfolio managers that look at companies like Facebook, Amazon, Apple, Google. So we have sectors, 8 different sectors like finance, tech, telecommunications. So I'm the point persons for our consumer staples sector. So think of companies like Coke, Pepsi, Frito-Lay, companies like that. So usually maybe a sector team lead might come to me saying, you know, you sent out a report yesterday. Could you follow up with a data request that I have? Or maybe they might be meeting a company within that sector and they just need some data about the company before they go into the meeting. Once I'm kind of done with that, I'll start working on my own quantitative projects. This can be pretty varied. It can be something like researching a new factor that we can add to our model. It could be a portfolio manager coming to me saying, hey, we had a client meeting yesterday. They asked a certain question. Can you find some data so that I can be better prepared for it going forward? Or it even could be helping them actively manage one of their portfolios. during the afternoon, then we'll usually have an external speaker come in. This could be like a CEO of a company talking about, you know, how the company is doing and what they're forecasting going forward. It could also be an industry analyst talking about market trends and industry trends that they've been noticing that might be helpful for portfolio managers to consider. Or it could be someone internal, maybe like a research analyst giving a sector overview about why certain stocks were a buy rated for us, but some stocks were a hold rated. So that'll be most of my afternoon. One really great thing that I've been working on that I'm really happy about is I'm a founding member of our music employee resource group. So it's about 30 individuals at MFS that really enjoy playing music and reading music together. So we usually have practices in the afternoon. Just last week, we had a retirement party for one of our longest tenure PMs. So we performed for him for a little bit on his favorite songs. So that's just been a great way to interact with other people across the firm. And it's a great way for me to continue my passion for alto sax and music.
That's amazing. That's great. So it sounds like you have a very full day. There's a lot going on, a lot of different people that you're working with. So how do you manage different priorities that you have from one key stakeholder to the next?
Yeah, I think that's a big part of the job, definitely. I like to write down everything in my OneNote and also in my notebook. So I'll have like my key priorities for the fundamental team, for the quant team, for portfolio managers, for research analysts. And then I think the next thing to do is to kind of prioritize it in order of importance. As I mentioned before, I work with a sector team. So if they have a request, usually it needs to be done by the end of the day. So if that request comes in, that probably takes top priority for me going forward, rather than maybe working on a long-term research project that I might be working on for the past 2 or 3 months. I think the other thing that's really important is also communication. My boss has been really great in allowing me to do a weekly check-in with him, where I get to actually talk about the things that I'm working on, what I might need help with, or who I've been talking to, you know, over the past couple of weeks. So that's just really great to communicate who I'm working with, how I'm working with it, and if I need really help. But I think, yeah, just those two things, you know, communicating with your managers about what you're working on and also being actively seeking out to, you know, write it down and to be on top of it is what I would recommend.
And is there a specific tool that you use at MFS that you use for communication within the company?
Yeah, we use a lot. We're mainly a Microsoft-based organization, so we use MS Teams and then also OneNote to write emails, and then we also use emails and then Zoom, or if we have to talk to someone, also MS Teams or Skype as well.
That's perfect. So talk to me a little bit about how you decided about MFS when you were leaving Fuqua and what your goal was when you came into the program.
Sure. So as I'd mentioned before, I was an undergraduate student at Northeastern University. So the distance between Northeastern University and MFS is like a stone's throw away. In my office, I can literally see my freshman dorm room that I stayed at Northeastern. So obviously Northeastern and MFS have a great connection with each other. I think every semester MFS employs around 30 to 40 co-op students from Northeastern. Co-op is basically, it's like an internship, but instead of only spending the summer or the winter periods, you're actually spending 6 months full time at the company and you're not taking any classes. So it's a great hands-on learning experience. So I had plenty of friends who had done co-ops prior at MFS, and they had nothing but great things to say. So it was definitely on my radar before coming to Fuqua. And at Fuqua, as I mentioned, I was on the finance track, so I definitely knew I wanted to stay in that realm. I had done finance previously in undergrad. So when I saw this opportunity come up for a quant research associate, I thought it was the perfect blend of taking my math and finance knowledge from both Northeastern and Duke, and also adding the technical skill set that I was learning at Duke, you know, such as, you know, the class of data infrastructure where we learned SQL queries, or taking the finance classes where we were also using Python and R. I thought it was a perfect marriage, and I'm very glad that they were able to accept me and add me to the team.
That's fantastic. And you mentioned you went to school at Northeastern, so you're living back in Boston again. What's your favorite thing to do in Boston?
Yeah, one of the great perks about MFS, Grady, is that we have a company suite at TD Garden, which is where the Boston Celtics and the Boston Bruins play, as well as box suites at Gillette Stadium. So during, as you know, Jason Tatum is a previous Duke alum. He's a great basketball player, and he plays for the Boston Celtics. So I was able to actually go to 3 different playoff series. I was able to go to the first round against the Hawks, the second round against the 76ers, and then the Eastern Conference Finals against the Miami Heat. So that's just been a great experience. I know they have box suites last week for the Patriots game against the Texans. And Grady, I know you're a big Boston sports fan. So next time you're in Boston, let me know and we'll see if we can get to a game.
Yeah, that sounds great. Yes, Vinaik and I would bond over our love for Boston sports. So it's great to hear that you're back up there and being able to get to go to all those games. That's great stuff. So you mentioned the office in your last answer. What is the office culture like and how does it compare to with any of your previous experience?
Yeah, the one word that I would describe the office culture is very collaborative. I'm a research associate, but I interact with analysts and PMs on a daily basis, and I don't feel nervous or shy about interacting with any of them. All of them have their offices open. They're more than willing to help if I have any questions for them. And even across the team, when I was getting in the elevator one day, the CEO was also in the same elevator. So I was just able to introduce myself, talk to him about the team I'm on and what I'm working, and he was very excited to have me as well. So that's just the kind of office culture that we have. I will also say though that MFS has, MFS used to stand for Massachusetts Financial Services, but the running joke at our company is that it stands for my final stop, because once people come to the company, they don't leave. Most of the portfolio managers that I have interacted with have been at the company longer than I've been alive. So that just goes to show you the kind of collaborative nature and the inclusive environment that they will have. I will also say though, I think MFS is also a very diverse company. We have five different generations working at the firm, from the silent generation to baby boomers to Gen X to millennials to Gen Z, which is my generation. And I do think that we're also pretty good with having diversity, equity, and inclusion. We hired a chief diversity, equity, and inclusion officer, and we have a lot of employee resource groups such as the women's employee resource group, the Latinx group, the South Asian group. So it's also a very diverse firm, which I really enjoy.
That's incredible. That's great to hear. And having a place where it is your final stop, if that is true, is always a great place because it really makes you feel comfortable and like you can really show who you authentically are. So with that being said, what do you hope to accomplish? What are your next steps with either in MFS or your next stops in general?
Yeah. So I'm currently a quantitative research associate, and this program is meant to be a 3 to 4 year program. So I'm about a year in. So I definitely have 2 to 3 to 4 years left in the program. So I would definitely like to continue down this path. I think the main exit opportunities for this one is either you get promoted internally as an analyst. A lot of prior RAs also go on to business school, most likely an MBA, or they explore opportunities externally outside of MFS. But I think I've had a great time at MFS. I hope to continue to get down into the RA program. And I'm also actively studying for the CFA. I was able to clear the level one in February of 2023, and I'll be taking my level two exam very shortly as well.
That's fantastic. I know those aren't easy, so good luck with those tests.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Last question for you is, what's one piece of advice that's to someone that's thinking about going into the quantitative research associate type of role?
Yeah, I think just knowing a good level of financial knowledge is just as important as knowing the technical skill set. Because at our role specifically, you're not just interacting with quants all day. You're also interacting with the fundamental team, you're interacting with sector teams, you're interacting with executives as well who might not know a whole lot about the quantitative jargon that you use on a daily basis. So I would say if you can read up as much as you can on Financial Times, the Wall Street Journal, I think that also helps you a lot during the interview process when you talk to a portfolio manager or you talk to an equity research analyst. And it kind of makes them also feel a little bit more comfortable that, hey, this person knows the technical skill set, but he or she can also apply it to a financial skill set as well.
That's perfect. Vinaik, it's always great talking to you. I will be sure to be in touch with you before my next trip up to Massachusetts. But it's great to hear all the success that you've had since leaving the MQM program. So thank you so much for your time today.
Great. Thank you, Grady. Appreciate it.